Hello everyone and welcome back to the Perfect French with Diane. Today we are on chapter 2 of the French vocabulary course. We are going to learn everything about les personnes, people. If you have the book, we are going from page 23 to 30. Exercises 2.1 to 2.8, which are all the exercises that are in chapter 2. So let's see all the points that we are going to see today. We are going to see les personnes et les membres de la famille, people and family members. Then we have a quick point about verbs that we used to talk about people. Les événements marquants, milestones. La naissance et l'enfance, so birth and childhood. Le mariage, marriage. La mort, death. And finally, LGBTQ. This does not include physical characteristics. Does not include jobs, it does not include anything like that, or nationalities, languages, etc. This is later in the course. I couldn't squeeze everything in one chapter, so you know we have to go step by step. So this is all chapter 2 of the book. But in this video, all those are different chapters. I know it's confusing. Chapter in the book, chapters in the video. So it basically means that you can go from one to the other. It's easier to navigate in the video if you want to. If you follow the book, all the pages and the exercises are going to be marked at the bottom of the screen. But it's very easy to just follow with the points like this. I am not going to give you all the vocabulary there is in the book because there's a lot of vocabulary in the book. I don't have time to give you everything, but I will give you the most important. The first one, les personnes et les membres de la famille. First, how do we talk about people? If you follow my channel for a long time, you already know this. But we are going to say, c'est Julie, ma sœur. It's Julie, my sister. Or, c'est ma sœur, Julie. The c'est is very important. It's a, it is, she is, etc. C'est is very versatile in French. Use it a lot. Technically, the good grammar, if you want to say they're my brothers, will be ce sont mes frères. It's not technically, this is the good grammar. Ce sont mes frères. But you will very often hear c'est mes frères. C'est mes frères. We tend to keep c'est as a singular masculine. So it's masculine, it's always masculine anyways. It never changes for feminine. But it should change for plural, which we tend to not do when we speak. In spoken French, we tend to just skip it. A little bit like il est. Do you know, il est as il est tard, il est l'heure, etc. We tend to keep c'est the same way as il est. Okay? So let's see the different type of family that we can find in the word. So family is la famille. La famille. And we can have une famille recomposée, une famille recomposée, une famille monoparentale. Une famille monoparentale. Or we can also have une famille homoparentale. Une famille homoparentale. All the people in the family are called les membres de la famille. Les membres de la famille. Membre is actually a very funny word in French. It can be a family member, but it can also be a member of an organization or something like that. But if you talk about an arm is un membre. So we can say il a perdu un membre, so he lost an arm or a leg. That's not in the book, it's just me, just talking. I hope I'm not going to make all the videos too long because I tend to speak a lot if I'm not structured, so we'll see. Since we are talking about people today, I'm going to use on most of the slides masculine, feminine. So masculine on the left, feminine on the right. I'm not going to write masculine, feminine because it takes a lot of space, but you know that un is masculine, une is feminine. So let's see. To say a husband, a wife, we can say un mari, une femme. Un mari, une femme. But we can also say un époux, une épouse. Un époux, une épouse. Une femme is going to be used again as a woman, une femme. Une femme, un homme. Une femme, un homme. For a boy and a girl, we have un garçon, une fille. Un garçon, une fille. Those are fairly easy. If you want to talk about men and women as father, mother, we'll say un père, une mère. Un père, une mère. A son, a daughter. Un fils, very specific pronunciation. Un fils, une fille. Un fils, une fille. Brother and sister. Un frère, une sœur. Un frère, une sœur. Now let's see how to name people regarding of their age. So we have un bébé. Un bébé. Un bébé is masculine and feminine. Then we have un enfant, une enfant, a child. Un adolescent, une adolescente, teenager. And then un adulte, une adulte. So those are the four, okay? Other members of the family will be un oncle, une tante, un oncle, une tante, un parrain, une marraine, un filleul, those ones are a little bit hard to pronounce, un filleul, une filleule, un filleul, une filleule, and un grand-père, une grand-mère. Un grand-père, une grand-mère. We'll come back on grand-père and grand-mère. Other family members are un cousin, une cousine. Those ones are very easy because it's so similar to English. Un cousin, une cousine. Then with those two that I want to mention, we have un gendre, une bru. Un gendre, une bru. So un gendre is a son-in-law. It is used in French, but une bru is not very used in French. It's just good to know that it exists. There is a word for daughter-in-law, just like gendre, but we never say, oh, this is my bru. C'est ma bru. Be weird. I don't know. We'll see more vocabulary about in-laws and stepdaughters, stepson, etc. in a minute. Two last for this category, we have un neveu, une nièce. Un neveu, une nièce. Now if you look at children, parents, grandchildren, etc. The first one, the children, are les enfants. Les enfants. So we saw it with un enfant, les enfants. Les enfants are just the children. Parents, les parents. Easy. Les parents. Parents. Then we have les grands-parents. Les grands-parents. And les petits-enfants. Les petits-enfants. So this is not like in English, we don't say les grands-enfants. We don't say that. We say les petits-enfants. Les petits-enfants. The little children. Les petits-enfants. Which can be un petit-fils, une petite-fille. Un petit-fils, une petite-fille. So that was for the general idea about family. Now let's see when we have half-brother, half-sister. This is very similar to English because we have un demi-frère, une demi-sœur. Un demi-frère, une demi-sœur. So those are very easy. It gets a little bit more complicated when we talk about step and in-laws. Simply because in French, they are exactly the same. The context will tell you more about who is who. But basically, if a man say my stepson in French, so mon beau-fils, he can be either the son of his new wife or the partner of his child. It can be any. So this is a little bit confusing. I've seen so many French learners being very confused about that, which I understand. But for us, we have exactly the same. I make the mistake as well because of this. Many times I refer to my father-in-law as my stepdad. And people are very confused, obviously. All right, enough talking. Let's see them. We have un beau-fils, which translates to beautiful, actually. A beautiful son, is it pretty? Une belle-fille, a beautiful daughter, une belle-fille. Un beau-frère, une belle-sœur. Un beau-frère, une belle-sœur. Do you remember that we saw beau, the adjective in the first lesson? Told you it would be useful. Une belle-sœur. Un beau-père, une belle-mère. And in general, we have les beaux-parents. Les beaux-parents. Un beau-père, une belle-mère, les beaux-parents. Now, if you just want to talk about friends and boyfriends, girlfriends. We have two different ways to call a friend in French. We have un copain, un ami. Un copain, un ami. It can be both. Usually un copain is a little bit less than un ami on the scale. So that's for like masculine. For feminine, we have une copine, une amie. Une copine, une amie. A best friend, masculine. Un meilleur ami. Un meilleur ami, féminine. Une meilleure amie. Une meilleure amie. So the pronunciation doesn't change. Now if we want to talk about girlfriend, boyfriend, for boyfriend we have un petit ami, un petit copain. Petit ami is more commonly used. For the feminine, une petite amie, une petite copine. I wrote a little text in the book. I will just take over the screen to share it with you because it's too long. Ma famille et moi sommes très proches. Je suis enfant unique, mais j'ai beaucoup de cousins, deux cousins et trois cousines. Mes grands-parents habitent près de chez nous. C'est parfait pour les réunions de famille. Ma tante et son mari s'occupent du repas. Mon parrain, qui est le meilleur ami de mon père, apporte toujours le dessert. Ma mère adore passer du temps en famille. Elle s'occupe toujours des enfants et particulièrement du bébé de sa belle-sœur, la sœur de mon père. Avec son mari, ils viennent juste d'adopter une petite fille. That's for the first one. You can do the exercise 2.1. Now we have 10 different verbs that we use to talk about people and their life in general. We have changer, devenir, être, grandir, mourir, naître, s'épanouir, survivre, vieillir et vivre. Let's see three sentences. Beaucoup de gens ont peur de vieillir. Beaucoup de gens ont peur de vieillir. C'est normal de changer dans la vie. C'est normal de changer dans la vie. Je suis devenue professeur après mes études. Je suis devenue professeur après mes études. That was a very quick point. You can do the exercise 2.2. Les événements marquants, milestones. La naissance is where everything starts. La naissance. The two next ones are apprendre à marcher, apprendre à parler. To learn to. Apprendre à marcher, apprendre à parler. Then we have commencer l'école. Commencer l'école. Then we start l'adolescence. L'adolescence. Something that can happen in life is le mariage, with the act of se marier. Le mariage, se marier. Sometimes followed as well by le divorce. Le divorce, divorcer. So you see how se marier is a reflexive verb and then divorcer is not. For some people as well, we have avoir des enfants. Avoir des enfants. Avoir un enfant, des enfants, the same. And finally, to retire, partir à la retraite. Partir à la retraite. Let's see a few sentences that I wrote for you. Apprendre à marcher, apprendre à parler et commencer l'école sont des événements marquants dans la vie d'un enfant. Après cela vient l'adolescence, le mariage et peut-être les enfants. Pour certains, le divorce est aussi une étape de la vie. Mais le but final de beaucoup de gens, c'est souvent de partir à la retraite. And we're already at exercise 2.3. La naissance et l'enfance. To get pregnant in French is tomber enceinte. Literally to fall pregnant. Tomber enceinte. Genre, oups. Tomber enceinte. You can also say être enceinte, to be pregnant. Être enceinte. To give birth is donner naissance à. Donner naissance à. Same as in English. Donner naissance à. To be born, naître. Naître. The birth, la naissance. La naissance. Naître, la naissance. You see? We works. Then we have accoucher, l'accouchement. Accoucher, l'accouchement. So accoucher, you can also translate to deliver. And I've heard people learning French who say that, you know, to deliver food, they say that it was accoucher as well, which I thought was funny. For the child, we can say un bébé, une enfant. Let's see the few sentences I wrote for you once again. Ma femme est enceinte de presque 9 mois. La naissance est prévue pour dans une semaine. Elle a un peu peur d'accoucher, mais on a hâte de rencontrer notre bébé. Exercise 2.4. Le mariage. Le mariage always starts, or most likely starts, with la demande en mariage. La demande en mariage. The act is demander en mariage. Demander en mariage. This term leads to a very, very common mistake in French. A lot of people say proposer for demander en mariage. But proposer, le verb proposer in French, is actually to suggest. So this is very different. False friends. If the person says yes, they are engaged. The act of getting engaged in French is se fiancer. Se fiancer. Engagement, les fiançailles. Les fiançailles. An engagement ring is going to be une bague de fiançailles. Une bague de fiançailles. And finally, fiancé is un fiancé, une fiancée. Un fiancé, une fiancée. When you study vocabulary in French, make sure to study everything by group. As you can see here, it's going to be very easy to remember it because se fiancer, les fiançailles, une bague de fiançailles, un fiancé, une fiancée, they're all the same group of words. They're from the same family. It's very easy to remember this way. You can really speed up your vocabulary with this method. When the engagement period is over, we are in the wedding. So we have se marier avec. I could have just said se marier, but I wanted to include the preposition se marier avec. The groom is le marié. Le marié. The bride, la mariée. La mariée. Newlyweds, les jeunes mariés. Les jeunes mariés. Which together are technically a couple, un couple. Un couple. You can be a couple, either you're married or not married, of course. For all the legal aspects, we have les témoins. Les témoins. Also, le garçon d'honneur. Le garçon d'honneur. La demoiselle d'honneur. La demoiselle d'honneur. And les demoiselles d'honneur. Les demoiselles d'honneur. Other words that can be useful around the wedding is la robe de mariée. La robe de mariée, wedding dress. Le costume, which is kind of confusing, this one, costume, costume. It's just a suit. Une alliance, wedding ring, une alliance. The ceremony is very close, la cérémonie. La cérémonie. And you get invited to it by receiving une invitation. Invitation. And you are un ou une invité. Les invités. The reception is very easy to remember. La réception. La réception. Another thing that is usually kind of the highlight of the wedding is les vœux. Les vœux. The vows. Les vœux. When all that is done, it's time for the honeymoon. Le voyage de noces. Le voyage de noces. And we have also la nuit de noces. La nuit de noces. And la lune de miel. La lune de miel. Which is the same as in English. Honeymoon. Lune de miel. Honeymoon. Time for little story. Un mariage peut coûter plusieurs dizaines de milliers d'euros. Entre la demande de mariage, l'achat de la bague de fiançailles, la robe de mariée, les alliances, la cérémonie, la réception et le voyage de noces, rien n'est gratuit. Certaines cultures célèbrent avec plus de 1000 invités. Chaque couple a le choix d'avoir un grand mariage ou un mariage plus discret. Exercise 2.5. Another type of event that is good to be able to talk about is la mort, death. We have three main verbs around this. We have mourir, mourir, which is the synonym of décéder. Décédé. And a lot of time it happens because people get ill. Tomber malade. Tomber malade. Just like tomber enceinte, tomber malade, to fall ill. The same way. So let's see. We have le décès, décédé, le décès. Le décès, le défunt, la défunte. Le défunt, la défunte. Le deuil, le deuil. Un cercueil, le chagrin. And un cimetière, un cimetière. So that's the general vocabulary. Now let's look a little bit more into it. When this happens, we can either se faire enterrer, être enterré. So se faire enterrer, être enterré. Why se faire? Because we don't do it ourselves. Someone is going to do it for us. Does that make sense? Se faire enterrer. Let me know if you would like me to make a video about se faire, a specific video about se faire. I can do that after the course. So, enterrer, un enterrement. Un enterrement. And in this case, there is une tombe. Une tombe. Another possibility is se faire incinérer. Être incinéré. Se faire incinérer. Être incinéré. Once again, we don't do it ourselves. So, se faire. Another action related to it will be disperser les cendres. Disperser les cendres. To scatter the ashes. The act is called la crémation. La crémation. So, les cendres are going to be kept in une urne. Une urne. Five other words related to this topic and then we move on. In many cultures, the ceremony is going to happen at the church. Une église. Une église. The funeral is called les funérailles. Les funérailles. Nom masculin pluriel. Les funérailles. The funeral home is called le funerarium. Funerarium. It's from Latin. Le funerarium. And finally, for the person who stays, we call them un veuf, une veuve. Un veuf, une veuve. A widow, a widower. Un veuf, une veuve. Should we see a little text again? La mort est inévitable. Personne ne peut choisir quand on meurt. Par contre, on peut choisir si on veut être enterré, donc dans un cercueil au cimetière, ou être incinéré. Si on choisit d'être incinéré, nos cendres sont placées dans une urne que nos proches peuvent garder ou disperser. Exercise 2.6. I just realized now that I totally forgot to add religion to the little table of contents at the beginning of the video. It's okay, it's not a very long subject, so it's really fine. If you want to say my religion is, in French we say ma religion est. Ma religion est. But you can also say, je suis, I am. Let's see both. I'm going to take over the screen once again because I don't have enough space. Ma religion est le bouddhisme. Je suis bouddhiste. Bouddhiste can be either an adjective or a noun. Ma religion est le christianisme. Je suis chrétien, chrétienne. L'hindouisme, hindou, hindou. L'islam, musulman, musulmane. Le judaïsme, juif, juive. So that's for the main religion. Of course, there are many, many other ones. I didn't include everything because it would have been a little bit long. But here are the main ones. Exercise 2.7. Now let's see LGBTQ+. New words have been added to the dictionary in the last few years to give a voice to all. The list in the book is as of now, when I'm filming, when I wrote the book. I will make sure to keep adding vocabulary when new vocabulary comes out. I'll make sure to add it as a little annex in the book. One of the major words added to the dictionary is the pronoun IL. IL is used for non-binary people. Because before that, we either have masculine or feminine. It's very complicated for the people who are non-binary. So now we have IL. which I will make a video about it after the course. Many of the vocabulary we are going to see is very, very close to the English ones. So those are very easy to learn. So for example, a person can be bisexuel, bisexuel. In this case, we are talking about bisexuality, bisexuality. All people are being represented by la communauté LGBTQ+. Many people have been fighting for it for a very long time. It's les droits des homosexuels. Les droits des homosexuels. To come out is called faire son coming out. It comes from English, so this one is very, very easy to remember. Faire son coming out. To say homosexual and heterosexual, we have un, une homosexuelle, so un homosexuel, une homosexuelle, and then we have also un hétérosexuel, une hétérosexuelle. It has nothing to do with gay right, hétérosexuel, but I think it's good to know. For gay woman, we have une lesbienne. Une lesbienne. A lesbienne. Une lesbienne. Gay marriage, we can either say le mariage gay, le mariage homosexuel. Le mariage gay, le mariage homosexuel. And finally, sexual orientation is also very close. We have l'orientation sexuelle. L'orientation sexuelle. There are more vocabulary in the book for all the chapters that we saw today and for all the chapters in general. I just want to add for this topic in particular that if you have the book and you think that I missed a word, an important word that you would like to be added, please just email me and I will make sure to add it. Let's see a few sentences. Mon frère a fait son coming out il y a quelques années. Mon frère a fait son coming out il y a quelques années. L'orientation sexuelle ne se décide pas. L'orientation sexuelle ne se décide pas. Sa tante est homosexuelle. Elle ne l'a jamais caché. Sa tante est homosexuelle. Elle ne l'a jamais caché. Last exercise for this one. You have 6 elements and you have to make sentences. That's it for today. Don't forget to like this video. It will really help me. We are only on lesson number 2 of the vocabulary course. There are 23 more. So to make sure that you don't miss any, please subscribe. On Monday, we are going to see everything about emotions and characteristics, which is a very, very big subject. So I will see you on Monday. À lundi.